And now let's put in Holden's chart of accounts. Because we already learned how to manage the chart of accounts, you might need to review video number 3 from level 1. This video assumes that you remember everything we learned in video number 3, level 1, when we put in the chart of accounts. Here are Holden's accounts. Notice the account list is different because Holden has a wedding video company and not a corner store. You might need to pause the video at this point to be able to read the information from the video screen and record them into QuickBooks. When we create this chart of accounts, we will do the following steps. Number 1, we will delete any accounts that QuickBooks put in. The accounts that QuickBooks put in are in lowercase, so they will be easy to see. Even though we chose other none for our industry and business type, QuickBooks still puts some accounts in the chart of accounts. We will try to delete the ones that QuickBooks put, and we will put in the ones that we need ourselves. 2, we will make inactive any accounts that we cannot delete. Some accounts that QuickBooks puts on the list we're not able to delete. So if we make them inactive, at least we won't be able to see them and they will not distract us. Then, of course, we will put in Holden's chart of accounts. You could read it from the video screen, or you could download the picture file that has all the accounts listed there, and you could read from the picture and put it into QuickBooks. It's your choice. And just remember, we will use all capital letters in the account name field. The reason why we want to use all capital letters in the account name field is because it is much easier to see the difference between the accounts that we put ourselves and the accounts that QuickBooks put on the list. In future videos and in future topics, QuickBooks will automatically add more accounts. The accounts that QuickBooks automatically adds will be in lowercase except for the first letter. But if our accounts are in all capitals, it will be easy to see the difference between the ones that we made and the ones that QuickBooks put on the list for us. So let's take a look at how to do it. As we learned before, from the main menu, click List, Chart of Accounts. Let's make the Chart of Accounts window nice and wide. Let's try and delete the accounts that we don't need. Right-click on Retained Earnings, Delete Account, click OK. Right-click on Opening Balance Equity, Delete Account, click OK. Now, when we right-click and try to delete payroll liabilities, we're not allowed to do that. So we will make it inactive. Right-click, Make Account Inactive. Let's try to delete payroll expenses. It will not allow us. So instead, we right-click and we click Make Inactive. Remember, you could always move to the bottom left and click Show Inactive Accounts, and move to the bottom left and click Hide Inactive Accounts. Those are the only two that will be inactive because QuickBooks created them and we don't want to use them. All the other accounts we will put ourselves. Just like we did before, from the bottom left of the Chart of Account window, click Account New. Now, this Account New window only comes up when we put in the first account on the list. It assumes we're putting it in one at a time, but we are not. Click Bank. It explains the type of account when we make the account type choice. Then when we click Continue, we get to the window that we will stay in for all of the remaining accounts that we will put on the list. Notice we could still change account type from bank to any other account. Make sure your cap locks is on. Type in cash in bank. And when we click Save and New, we can see that cash in bank, both name and type, have been added to the chart of accounts. Now, keep this window open, just choose the next type of account. The next type of account for the next account on the list is accounts receivable, and it also happens to be the name, accounts receivable. Now, do not click Save and Close. Click Save and New. And when we take a look at the chart of accounts, we can see the name and the type have been added to the list. The next type is Other Current Asset, and the next name is Supplies. Click Save and New, and notice the name and the type have been added to the list. Keep going. Fixed Asset, the next one is Equipment. Save and New. Then the next one was Account Payable Type, and the name actually was Accounts Payable. Save and New. Then, of course, we have Video Income. And we know that Video Income is an income type of account. Save and New. Leave it as Income because we're also going to type in Editing Income. Save and New. And the rest of the accounts on our list are expenses. Delivery expense. Save and New. Electric expense. Save and New. Repair expense. Save and New. And of course, telephone expense. And the last one, if you want, you can click Save and Close. Now, when we expand the window, we see that all the accounts that we had listed in our chart of accounts are listed here, both in name and in type. For some reason, QuickBooks brought back the opening balance equity, but you notice it's in lowercase, whereas the accounts that we put are in capital. This will help our eyes see clearly the difference between the accounts that we made and the accounts that QuickBooks made.